con crunch. Whether or not you've experienced it yourself, we've all heard of this terrifying time when the con is in a week and your costumes are definitely not done at all. Needless to say, for those of us who have very little self-control, this usually leads to a frantic week of trying to finish everything in time for the convention. And this usually happens at the expense of ourselves. If you happen to follow me on Instagram and Twitter, you know that I have been through my fair share of con crunches. It usually involves tweeting about burning my fingers with Warbla or posting selfies at 4 a.m. while I'm crying over my sewing machine. Trust me, this year's Katsu Crunch was not my first rodeo. So having made it through my fair share of con crunches and live to tell the tale, I'd like to share some advice that can help you with your next con crunch nightmare. Number one, remember to get a full 8 hours of sleep every single night. Number two, make sure to eat plenty of healthy meals, really taking the time to slow down and enjoy them. Number three, decorate your to-do list with lots of cute stickers that will really help calm you down when you start to feel stressed out, because you totally have time to sit there and scrapbook right now. Number four, indulge in a bubble bath, wasting all of your expensive bath bombs because you'll be too busy freaking out about all the costumes you should be working on to actually enjoy the bath. Number five, light soothing candles and pretend that a good smell is actually going to do jack to help you feel better about the five costumes you still have to finish in the next 72 hours and okay, I am done, I cannot keep doing this. We all know that is not happening. That is not how con crunch works. Because anyone who has been through it knows that con crunch means running on 3 to 4 hours of sleep, if you get any at all. Barely remembering to eat because you can't justify the time away from your sewing machine. And straight up forgetting to shower because hygiene is not important when you have to paint armor. If you've been through con crunch, you know that taking bubble baths and lighting incense is not gonna happen. So instead, here is some practical and realistic advice on how to actually survive con crunch. First up, you need to sleep. I know you don't want to. You'd rather pull 3 consecutive all-nighters, but I'm telling you, don't do it. Just don't do it. It's not worth it, especially because being sleep deprived will actually cause you to make mistakes while you're trying to make your costumes, and in the long run, that will actually hinder you and waste your time. It's better to get at least 5 to 6 hours of sleep, if not the full 8 hours, a night and actually be able to focus on your costumes with a clear head instead of fighting to keep your eyes open while trying to sew that corset. Remember to eat. And if that means setting an alarm on your phone for every meal break, so be it. Any artist knows it is so easy to fall into that creative groove and then look at the clock and realize, oh, it's 9 p.m. and I forgot to eat lunch and dinner. Just like a lack of sleep, a lack of proper nutrition can cause you to make mistakes on your costumes. Try to shower every other day at least. Doesn't have to be your full routine. You don't have to shave right now. Save the bath bombs for later when you can enjoy them guilt-free. Right now, just aim to rinse off the filth. Not only will you feel better and re-energized, but this will also help reduce the chances of a breakout happening before the convention. No, you don't have to smell nice when you're sitting in your house sewing all day. So do it for future you and the skin of future you. Future you will thank you. Seriously, make a to-do list. No, it doesn't have to be in a cute decorated planner, but writing out a list of every task you have to accomplish for Con Crunch will keep you focused, stop you from being overwhelmed up in here, and prioritize what absolutely needs to get done. During Con Crunch, your to-do list is your greatest ally. It is the tuxedo mask to your Sailor Moon, the Genos to your Saitama, the Donald Duck to your Sora, but this is a Donald Duck that actually heals you. And finally, I want to leave you with some real talk with Mango. These are some lessons that I learned during Katsu Crunch 2K16, and I want all of you to really take them to heart. Seriously, learn from your senpai's mistakes. Number one, do not wait until the last minute to use a new material or a new technique that you've never worked with before and expect it to go flawlessly. It won't. Number two, always have a plan B. Even if you think plan A will work, have that backup plan just in case. Number three, speaking of time, even if you have a solution for a construction problem, you may not have the actual hours to make it happen. You may know exactly how to finish that prop, but you just physically do not have the time to sand it and primer it and paint it and finish it and seal it. Like, you just don't have time. That deadline is 2 to 3 days before the actual eve of the convention. Number four, every failure is a learning experience. It's frustrating and demoralizing, but this hobby is built on trial and error. Such is the nature of cosplay. We're trying to make things that don't exist, exist. We're gonna mess up occasionally. Number 5, at some point, you're gonna have to make the call of whether or not finishing your costumes is worth it to start off the weekend already exhausted. Do you really wanna show up for a 3 to 4 day event having not slept for a week? Do you really think you're gonna have a great time? Really? You're not. Number 6, you also have to decide if it's worth it to rush this costume and have a subpar result that you'll have to fix later, or just save it for when you can take your time and have a finished product that you're really proud of. Number 7, if you cannot finish a costume in time, it is okay. The world will not end. You can finish the costume some other time. You will still have fun at the con. Everything will be all right. Number 8, Con Crunch can be fun and the productivity and the adrenaline can be really addictive, but it's not worth the expense of your health. Know where that line is. Number 9, it's easy to get caught up in the things that are going wrong and lose confidence. Step back. Look at what you've already accomplished during this Con Crunch period. You've already done so much, and that alone is something to be proud of. Number 10, remember, cosplay is a hobby. I'm saying this as someone who has been there. If you are sobbing over your sewing machine the night before a convention trying to finish a costume, it's time to call it quits. Just wear something else. And please, go take a bubble bath. You deserve it. That about wraps it up. To reiterate one last time, cosplay is about having fun. And I think we can all agree, showing up to the convention sick, exhausted, and completely drained from trying to finish costumes for the weekend is not fun. I personally have decided that I am way too old to keep putting myself through Con Crunch, so from here on out, I'm donezies. But if you young whippersnappers still feel like attempting it, please, take care of yourselves. You are more important than a costume. If you have any Con Crunch survival tips of your own, leave them in the comments below, and feel free to subscribe for more cosplay videos. I'm Mango Cyrene, wishing you all the best of luck with your Con Crunch, and please, happy cosplay. Happy. Fun. Not crying over your sewing machine. I don't want any one of you crying over your sewing machine. What you doing?